Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to do contour plots in Stata. So let's open some example data by clicking File here at the top left, scrolling down to Example Datasets, and we're going to click Stata 12 Manual Datasets, and then Graphics Reference Manual, and we're going to be using the sandstone data. So let's click Use next to that, and notice our dataset is open in the Variables window. We have three variables that we're interested in here: easting, northing, and depth. Essentially, a contour plot is a way of graphing three-dimensional data in two dimensions. So it's easier to show than to describe. So let's just click Graphics here at the top and scroll down to Contour Plot. Now notice that Contour Plot, when you click that, it doesn't open the dialog box, it opens a help menu, and it points you in the right direction. That Contour Plots is actually a special case of two-way plots. So if we click Two-Way, Stata will open the two-way dialog box for us, so we can close that help menu. So we're in the two-way dialog box, so to create our contour plot, let's click Create, select Contour Plots, and we're going to leave everything at the default for now, and select our X variable. So again, this is essentially three-dimensional data. So our X variable, let's select easting, which is going to describe the position of the sample in the east and west direction. For the Y variable, let's select northing, which is going to describe the north and south position of our sample. And then the Z variable is going to be depth, which is the depth from which our sample was taken. Again, these are sandstone samples. So let's move this dialog box over and click Accept, and now click Submit. And let's just see what the default graph looks like. Okay. So exactly what we asked for. The vertical axis is northing, so up is north and down is south. The horizontal axis is easting, east and west. And then the depth of the sample is represented by the colors. So blue samples were taken at higher depths, and red samples were taken at lower depths, down to 8,100 feet. Okay, so that's a basic contour plot. Now there are lots of options that we have. If we click Edit back on the dialog box, we could do this as a line plot instead if you don't want the colors, or if for some reason you need to do this in black and white. So we can select Contour Line and Submit. Let's go back to color though. So I clicked Contour and Submit again. One of the things you might want to do is change the number of levels. So we might want to increase the resolution of our graph, so to speak. So instead of having five levels, which is the default in this case, we could select 10 and submit that, and we get a slightly finer resolution graph with 10. And we could do 20 or 30 or whatever. We can change the colors, all kinds of things, and I'll refer you to the manuals for those options. Now, one thing I'd like to point out is the structure of the data for contour plots, because that's very important. This is essentially three-dimensional data. We have three variables, easting, northing, and then the depth, which means for each depth in this graph, for each point, we need both an X and a Y position, an easting and a northing position, which means that the data are actually, this is a fairly large data set. If we go back and click on the data editor in browse mode and look at these three variables, for northing, we have a value for northing of 60,840, and if we scroll down, we see that there are a lot of values of 61,840. We have to have an easting value for each of those, as well as a particular depth at that point. So this is actually a fairly large data set, and if you want to do, relatively. So if you want to do these kinds of graphs, that's the structure of the data. You'll need, for every depth point, you'll need both a horizontal and a vertical position for that point. Okay? So that's how we do contour plots in Stata. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.